Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, and His love endures forever. Enter His gates with thanksgiving, and His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him, bless His name. Surely the righteous shall live thankful lives in Your name. The upright shall dwell in Your presence. All Your works shall give thanks to You, O Lord, and all Your saints bless Your holy name. Give thanks to the Lord, call upon His name. Make known His deeds among the peoples. Proclaim that His name is exalted. Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated. My dearest brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, oh, give thanks. And we hardly need a congressional act, much less do we need a presidential decree, or even a national day of thanksgiving, to know that it is right and proper and good that we give thanks. It's all over the Psalms, which you've just heard. Not only that, it's all over Scripture, from Genesis to Revelation. To give thanks, dear one, is what faith does. It's a byproduct of faith. In fact, you might even say, to be a Christian is to be thankful. It is truly good, right, and salutary that we at all times and in all places give thanks to you, O Lord, words that you'll be hearing very soon. And that is also right and good and true and proper. It simply goes with faith. It's like the one faithful leper who returned to give thanks at the feet of Jesus. Moses reminded the Israelites, as you heard in the Old Testament lesson this morning, don't forget who you were, where you came from, how you got this good land. And you shall eat and be full, and you shall bless the Lord your God for the good land that He has given you. And then Moses gave a warning. Take care, lest in that day you forget. Lest you forget that you were once slaves. Lest you forget the Lord who brought you out of Egypt. Lest you forget that it is He who led you through the wilderness. Lest you forget the land that was inherited by mercy, not by merit. Beware. Beware lest you say in your heart, my power and my might of my hand have gotten me this wealth. You shall remember the Lord your God, for it is He who gives you power to get wealth. Yes, my dear brother and sister, thanksgiving is remembering. Remembering the giver of the gifts that we all enjoy. It's not simply a matter of counting one's blessings. Thanksgiving is not an inventory, but a response to the giver. Remembering that all that we have, all that you have, has come from the hand of God Almighty. Oh yes, it for sure, we must do this. We must thank the farmer. We must thank the butcher and the baker. Yes, even maybe even the candlestick maker. And everyone else who serves us. It is good and right that we do this. Everyone likes to hear a word of thanks. But working in and with and under all of this, all of them, is God. It is His fatherly goodness and His mercy which provides and protects His good creation. And because God is hidden behind these masks, as Dr. Luther would write, we all too often forget to give thanks to God from whom all blessings flow. We also forget to give thanks to God when we are anxious, when we are worried, when we are in distress. Our focus is so centered on what we don't have, whatever is causing us anxiety, that we forget oh so quickly what we do have. This is especially true when it comes to the second and third article gifts from the Creed. You know the second article gift, the gift of Christ, which is redemption. And you know that third article gift, the gift of the Holy Spirit, which is sanctification. We forget our baptism. We forget our new birth in Him. We forget that we are forgiven children and that forgiveness is spoken in His name. All too often, especially on Thanksgiving, too many forget about His body and His blood that strengthens and preserves the faith that He has given to you as a free gift. Jesus warned His disciples that the cares and concerns of this life can and will choke out the Word like weeds choking the good seed. Do you remember? He told them, "Don't be anxious for the things of this life, what you will eat or drink, what you will wear. For your Father in heaven knows that you need them. And He who cares for the birds of the air and the lilies of the field will certainly care for you, His children." And so this brings us to the Apostle Paul. Paul, as he was writing the book of Philippians, maybe you've forgotten, but you should remember, he's writing this great book of joy from prison. What did he write? "Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God." No matter what your circumstance may be, no matter what the cause of your anxiety, no matter why you are praying, give thanks to the Lord. Give thanks, not as a business deal, dear one. Yes, I know in the news you've been hearing this fancy Latin term, quid pro quo. You must not approach God with a quid pro quo because you will lose every time. You see, giving thanks to God is not a quid pro quo. It's not a business deal. It's not what you hope to receive for Him. It's not, "Thank you in advance, God, for listening to me. And since you are listening to me, then I'll know you'll give this to me." No, we are to give thanks to God for what brought you to prayer in the first place, the faith that He has given you. Yes, remember. Remember that Paul has lost his liberty. He's a prisoner. Yet he's writing to the Philippians who have sent him a generous gift, and he's writing them a thank you letter. A thank you letter that is full of joy, even as he sits in the squalor of a prison. And he goes on to say, "For I have learned in whatever situation that I am in to be content. I know how to be brought low, and I know how to abound. In any and every circumstance, I have learned the secret of facing poverty and hunger, plenty and abundance in every need." So what is Paul's secret? Listen carefully. Here's Paul's secret. "I can do all things through Him who strengthens me." All things through Christ, who gives you strength, who gave Paul strength, who gives me strength. This is how Paul, this is how you can give thanks in any and all circumstances. You can do this through Jesus Christ, who, even though Jesus had no place to lay his head, he trusted in his Father and lived the perfect life of thanksgiving on behalf of each and every one of you. Yes, I know, it's hard to give thanks sometimes. Our restless hearts are content not only in Jesus, but our restless hearts are content within many, many things of this world. But you should know that only thanksgiving that flows from God flows through Jesus. Remember the 1 out of 10? There was one who actually truly believed, who was faithful. He returned to the feet of Jesus and gave thanks and praised God. And he was a foreigner, a Samaritan. Now, he may have argued, or he could have argued, that he was on the way to the temple anyway, so therefore there's no reason to give thanks to God. It's done. Why bother to go back? But faith, dear one, it is faith that drives him back to the feet of his Lord. And it's from Jesus that this foreigner, this Samaritan, hears those most beautiful words, "Rise and go your way. Your faith has made you well." Oh, the others were also healed, no doubt. But this foreigner, was saved in the fullest sense of the word. Not simply cleansed from leprosy, but cleansed from the leprosy of sin and rescued from death by Jesus, who is the Christ, the Anointed One, the Messiah, the Redeemer. It is good to give thanks to God. It is good for you to be here, resting, as it were, at the feet of Jesus, to give thanks for everything that you do have, the bounties of this land, the freedoms that you do enjoy, the food that will be on your table at dinner time and supper time, the clothing that you have on your back, the roof over your head, your wife, your husband, your children, your grandchildren, all of your relatives, all are a gift from a good and gracious Father, for all of which is our duty as priest of God, to thank and praise and serve and obey Him. Yes, it is your priestly duty, and it is your privilege, dear one, as a Christian, to give thanks, not only for yourself, but also for your neighbor and for this good land. Thanksgiving, dear one, is what you do. It's who you are. So whether the nation of Israel, which is about to take possession of the promised land, or St. Paul in prison, or the one leper who returned to Jesus to fall at his feet and to worship him, or you, yes, you, his dear child, a recipient of God's rich grace in Jesus Christ, give thanks to the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, and His steadfast love endures forever. And finally, and to you, you too shall endure forever and ever in Christ Jesus your Lord. Thanks be to Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please.